Good news, everyone! Keysight Technologies has sent me an oscilloscope to review. I'm going to be reviewing the high-end 3104T 1GHz mixed-signal oscilloscope. And just so you know, they're letting me keep a lower-end version of this scope in exchange for the time I spent making this review. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started. The 3104T is part of Keysight's 3000T series of oscilloscopes. These are a replacement for Keysight's 3000A scopes, so don't bother with those. Get a 3000T series instead because they have touchscreens and other cool new features. Now, the first question you might have is, who are Keysight Technologies? Well, basically Keysight is Agilent. You already know Agilent, I've been buying their stuff for years and you've seen them in my videos before. I got the inside story on the name change and here it is. Basically, Agilent used to make test equipment for both electronics and life sciences, and now they've decided to split the company, so Keysight focuses on electronic test equipment only, allowing them to invest more of their profits into developing better products. Okay, on with the review. Let's start with the biggest feature of this scope, the touchscreen. One of the nicest things the touchscreen gives you is an on-screen keyboard. With every scope I've ever owned, I had to either awkwardly input text with a single knob or keep notes with a pen and paper. This is really annoying when you're trying to capture multiple images and explain things to other engineers. Now you can just type things out. You can also add annotations to each waveform, which is great for documentation and teaching purposes. And you can have up to 4 annotations on screen at once. You can drag waveforms around. And you can use the screen to add and remove up to 8 automatic measurements. You can basically control everything with the touchscreen. So I really like it, and it doesn't seem to collect fingerprints either. We're living in a world where everyone has come to expect a touchscreen interface as a standard thing, and I'm hoping that more companies start doing this. If for some reason you don't like it, you can just disable it. The scope also comes with a screen protector in case you're carrying it around. Other than the touchscreen, it's worth mentioning that the screen resolution is 800x480, and it's really nice to look at. It's a bit brighter than my 2000 series, and the colors seem more vivid and contrasty. It kind of looks like something you'd see on a tablet rather than a scope, and my camera can't really do it justice. The build quality of the scope is, in a word, flawless. All the buttons and dials feel nice, and you can do the classic push to center trick on each channel. Now I want to talk about triggers. The other thing you can do with the touchscreen is a thing called zone triggering, and let me give you an example. I have a demo set up here with a digital signal that has a rare glitch. The fading on the intensity graded display tells us that this glitch doesn't happen very often, but it is there. Standard triggering methods and single shot mode are just not going to reliably capture it. But what we can do now is set up a trigger for whenever there's a signal in this area on the screen. Now we're only viewing the glitchy signal. Similarly, I can create a zone where the signal must not intersect, and now I can view the waveform only when the glitch never happens. There are lots of other special triggers you can use too, such as a pattern trigger that allows you to trigger on specific data. You can trigger on different rise times, which is useful for digital designers. If your edges are too slow, you might violate a timing requirement. If your edges are too fast, you might violate an EMC requirement. Other options include triggering on runt pulses, and serial decoding and triggering for a lot of different protocols. Note that the serial decoding and triggering is not a standard option, you have to pay extra for it. Here's an example I have set up where I'm triggering on the hash character in an RS-232 stream of data. It's crazy watching this happening in real time, and it really changes the way you think about debugging. I'll talk more about the serial decoding later in the review. It's worth mentioning that the scope comes with 500 MHz passive probes. You get these for everything in the 3000T series. So, if you buy a 100 MHz model, you're getting 500 MHz probes. But if you buy the 1 GHz model, and you want to take advantage of all that bandwidth, you're going to have to buy higher bandwidth probes separately. The 3000T series has extra connectors next to the BNC jacks. These are for Keysight's auto probe interface, which allows you to use active single-ended and active differential probes. Active probes have little amplifiers close to the probe's tip, which results in less capacitive loading when you're performing measurements. Active probes are ideally what you want to use when working with high-frequency electronics, because even a few picofarads of loading or long test leads can throw off your measurements, affect rise and fall times, and even add instability to oscillators and PLLs. The other thing you get with the 3000T series is the ability to do 50 ohm termination. This is an oscilloscope feature that you don't see talked about very often, and I think it's very underrated. Pretty much all low-end oscilloscopes only let you terminate into 1 mega ohm. 50 ohm termination is useful when you want to make high frequency measurements or do RF work. If you set things up correctly, you can match the impedances, minimize reflections, and get more accurate readings. The next feature I want to talk about is the waveform update rate. Keysight are very proud of the fact that you can get over 1 million waveforms per second, regardless of how many features you have enabled. The result is a display that looks very much like an old school analog oscilloscope, with all of the benefits of digital storage and measurement. Check out this amplitude modulated waveform. Even my 2000 series with its 50,000 waveforms per second sometimes struggles with this test. Now, from a marketing perspective, 1 million waveforms per second sounds amazing, but from an engineering perspective, I think it's better to think of it like this. You only have to wait a microsecond before you can re-trigger. Entry-level scopes might only capture a few hundred or even a few dozen waveforms per second, meaning you'd have to wait many milliseconds before you can recapture anything. And in electronics, a lot can happen in a few milliseconds. It's a huge pain waiting around for rare events that may or may not be randomly captured, so the more waveforms you can capture per second, the better. Here's an example using one of the built-in demo signals. We've got a clock signal that occasionally glitches. It's so rare that you're not going to be able to see it with your eyes. If we enable persistence mode, we can very quickly see the glitches. The faster the scope's update rate, the quicker you can capture the problem, and in theory, you could end up waiting for hours. Now if I set up a zone trigger, we can observe the glitch and only the glitch. Next, let's talk about capture memory. You can record up to 4 megapoints, which isn't much. You can get 12 megapoints on low-end scopes nowadays. But by default, the 3000T series comes with a feature called segmented memory. This is a Keysight exclusive, and let me explain how this works. I have a demo set up here where I'm sending a short burst of serial data every 100 milliseconds. This is a pretty common situation if you've ever worked with sensors. Normally, if you want to view the data, you'd have to capture it, zoom in, and then spend a lot of time navigating the dead space between each reading. You end up wasting capture memory. Segmented memory allows you to capture analog and/or digital data in useful segments. Here I'm going to capture 10 consecutive trigger events at a timescale that's actually useful to me, and I can quickly browse through them with the touchscreen. Check this out. Even though you only have 4 megapoints of memory, you can capture up to 1,000 segments. Just be aware that you might lose some detail if you capture that many. Now let's talk about the FFT function. This allows you to view the frequency content of a signal. Here I've got a 433 MHz signal coming out of my tracking generator. The update rate is extremely fast. In some situations, it's faster than a spectrum analyzer. But this is absolutely not a substitute for a real spectrum analyzer if you want to do serious RF work. On a real spectrum analyzer, you'd clearly see more detail on the distortion. The dynamic range on an 8-bit oscilloscope ADC just isn't wide enough. The FFT is useful for measuring the fundamental frequency of a waveform and maybe a couple of the larger components, and that's about it. So here's a practical example where I'm characterizing the frequency content of some noise on a power supply. You could then design suitable filters to deal with it. And here's an example of the gated FFT. I have a signal switching between 1 MHz and 25 MHz. Let's do a waveform capture, and if I use the zoom button, I can choose the time window for the FFT. Now I'd like to show you one of the built-in demos from the scope to show you what's theoretically possible with a time-correlated gated FFT. The idea is that if you buy the extra serial decode options, you can use one of the fancy I2C triggers to observe the exact moment the frequency changes in an FSK signal. Overall, I think the time-correlated frequency analysis is a nice feature to have, and I don't know of any other scope in this price range that can do it. Just keep your expectations realistic. Serious RF engineers are not going to find this to be a substitute for a more expensive spectrum analyzer or MDO. Finally, I want to open up the math menu. There are more options here than you will ever know what to do with. here's an example of a low-pass filtered square wave where I'm changing the cutoff frequency to whatever I want. Being able to do this on the fly is pretty mind-blowing. Most of the things I've talked about so far are what you get with just the oscilloscope, and now's a good time to talk about pricing. The lowest-end version of the scope costs $3,350, but I think the type of person who would use this scope would be better off getting at least the 4-channel 200 MHz mixed signal version for just under $6,000. The scope I reviewed in this video is the top-of-the-line 1 GHz bandwidth model, and that goes for $15,400, and that's without the extra options. Clearly, this is not an oscilloscope for hobbyists. This is a scope for engineering and military professionals, and maybe grad students. It's worth noting that if you buy a 3000T, you can buy software or hardware bandwidth upgrades later. For example, if you buy the 100 MHz model, you can get a license to upgrade it to 200 MHz. But if you want to upgrade it beyond that, you're going to have to send it to Keysight for the upgrade. Now let's talk about the extra add-ons you can get for the scope, and there are a lot of options. I'm going to talk about some of the most popular individual options you can get, and then I'm going to talk about the all-in-one bundle. The biggest upgrade you can get is the 16-channel logic analyzer, which turns your oscilloscope into a mixed signal oscilloscope. The price difference here is $1,500. You can use it to analyze two different serial buses simultaneously in hardware in real time. And you can decode just about every protocol out there, I2C, SPI, RS-232, FlexRay, and more. The only thing you can't decode with a scope is USB. You have to get a Keysight 4000 series for that. The serial triggering and segmented memory work together amazingly well, allowing you to replay what happened in your circuit at different times. And you can use the scope's search options to search the recorded data for specific events like alert conditions, specific characters, or even just low-level transmission errors. The only thing you can't search for is entire strings of decoded data. I just showed you RS-232, but you can trigger and search on all kinds of different events depending on the serial protocol you're using. You can do all of this stuff with zero performance penalty to the scope's 1 million waveforms per second. It's a really powerful tool for anyone designing or debugging mixed signal designs. But there's a catch. If you buy the mixed signal functionality, you can only trigger and view data in hex or binary. You don't get to actually decode protocols like I just showed you. If you want to do that, you'll have to spend about $1,100 for each individual protocol you want to decode. I personally think this is really expensive, and if you ever plan on decoding more than one protocol, you should just get the all-in-one bundle that I'll talk about later. The next thing you can get is the LAN and VGA module. You can use it to email your annotated screenshots to the rest of your engineering team. I have that set up with a quick action button here. This is a really big time saver, and it helps keep you more organized. You can also send images to a networked printer and control the oscilloscope remotely via your web browser. It uses VNC, so you don't need any extra software. It even works on tablets. At $400, I think this is a great upgrade to get for anyone working in an office environment. The scope connected to my network via DHCP, and it was one of the easiest things I've ever set up. For $750, you can get the waveform generator option. This uses the extra BNC output on the front of the scope. I'm going to connect it to channel 1 and show you what it can do. It can generate a variety of test waveforms. The maximum frequency depends on the waveform. You can go up to 20 MHz for sine waves, 1 MHz for things like sync waves, and 200 kHz for cardiac pulses. Hopefully you're not running into that problem in real life. You can modulate the waveforms with AM, FM, and FSK. I found it generates very smooth waveforms, but there is a big limitation. The output is limited to 5 volts peak-to-peak for high impedance loads and 2.5 volts peak-to-peak for 50 ohm loads. This may or may not be enough for your needs. You can also design your own arbitrary waveforms, but I felt that even with a touchscreen, the process was kind of awkward. If you do this a lot, you'd be better off using their waveform builder software. I used to use this with my benchtop generator, and it's the best waveform editing software I've ever used. It's way more powerful and stable than any software I've used from cheaper manufacturers, but unfortunately it costs as much as a cheap AWG. Check out the free 30-day trial before buying. Given the price of the waveform generator option, you need to decide how much bench space you have and whether it's worth just buying a separate AWG or just go for the all-in-one bundle. Another feature you can buy is the voltmeter and frequency counter combo. The idea here is that it uses separate circuitry from the scope's ADC to make measurements, so it's going to be more accurate. You'd use this for things like checking power rails and reference voltages. The problem here is it's only 3 digits, so for a lot of people it's not going to replace your bench meter. I think the 8-digit frequency counter and totalizer is more interesting. Frequency counters are one of those instruments that I love to hate because every engineer needs one, but you tend to use them only for short periods of time, so they usually just sit around taking up space. Regardless of the bandwidth of the scope, this frequency counter can count up to 1 GHz, so you could use it for checking the accuracy of clock signals, and maybe checking the carrier frequency of a key fob or RFID application. At $150, if you don't already have a frequency counter, this option is a no-brainer. Another upgrade you can get is the Educator's Kit for $521. This gives you a bunch of test signals that can be internally generated by the scope, and then you can learn how to analyze them. Professional designers are obviously not going to go for this, but I can see it being useful for universities and training technicians. There are a lot of students out there who graduate still addicted to the autoscale button. I ended up using some of these signals while testing the scope because the alternative was to spend hundreds of dollars on evaluation boards or spend weeks designing my own. Now I want to show you the power measurement and analysis option. I used to design power electronics for a living, so this really excites me. If you buy suitable probes, you can measure real and reactive power, calculate the power factor, and measure the phase angle all on the fly. If you're doing EMC testing, it can measure the current harmonics for you. You can measure switching losses and see the energy loss per switching cycle, which will help you make decisions about choosing your switching frequency. There's also a mode where you can measure the on resistance and saturation voltage of the transistors in circuit, so you're not just relying on theoretical values from a datasheet. Imagine being able to do this at different temperatures. Now check this out. If you buffer the scope's internal waveform generator output, you can inject a signal into your power supply and create a bode plot of the power supply rejection ratio at different frequencies. To be able to do this with one instrument is insane. There are other power measurement options as well, but those were my favorite time savers. This option costs $1,400, and if you design power electronics, it's worth way more than that. For $1,100, you can test eye diagrams in hardware. You can do this on cheaper oscilloscopes, but the 3000 T-Series lets you do it at over 200,000 waveforms per second. Depending on your test requirements, this could be overkill or it could save you a lot of time. Just so you know, there are even more options that you can get for the scope, but I don't want this review to get too long. Check out the links in the video description section to see all the possibilities. Now I want to talk about the bundle. As you noticed, I wasn't too happy about the pricing on some of these options, so I talked to Keysight about this. It turns out you can buy all of the software options in one upgrade. For $2,750, you get everything. The waveform generator, multimeter, frequency counter, all of the serial decoding and triggering options, training signals, power measurement, everything. Unless you specifically want only one option, I think this is what you should get. So how do I wrap this review up? It's a hell of an oscilloscope. The touchscreen is addictive. After 2 weeks of using it, I found myself tapping my other equipment and forgetting I can't do that. Between the 1 million waveforms per second, zone triggering, 4 megapoints of segmented memory, and advanced measurement functions, there's clear product differentiation between the 3000 T-Series and the 2000 X-Series. This wasn't really the case with the older 3000 A's. I think a 3000T MSO with the all-in-one bundle would be a really great choice for any professional digital or mixed signal designer or anyone working with power electronics. If you want to decode USB, check out the 4000 series, which is going to be very similar, but even more powerful. Keysight are also on YouTube. If you want to check out their products and watch a few tutorials, subscribe to their channels. Thank you for watching!